Hi there, my name is Aaron Short and welcome to my YouTube channel. On today's episode of Music Apps with Coffee, we're looking at Lumbeat's Rock Drummer or Rock DM. Let's go. So I had to decide which app I'm going to start with. There's so many apps. There's so many great apps. These apps are some of the first that I've found. They're very well regarded. These are drum machine apps made by Lumbeat. First thing to know about these apps is there's not just one app with in-app purchases. I kind of wish there were. There's actually many apps. They're all broken into separate apps. So if you play jazz, you buy the jazz drum app. If you play reggae, you buy the reggae drummer app. If you play singer-songwriter stuff, you buy the soft drummer app. They're all separate. They're all great. Unfortunately, they are all updated at slightly different times because they're all separate apps and not one. So I know some features are coming to Rock Drummer. I want to show Rock Drummer because I like it and it's something I would use in my band gigs. So I'll start with this, but I know there's new features that will probably make its way down to this one from Soft Drummer. Soft Drummer is the most recent app at time of this video, which is August 2020. So this app is available both on iPhone and iOS, which I love. I wish all apps were on both iPad and iPhone because I always have my phone with me, which is a great thing. But the iPad version obviously is easier to see on stage and use on stage. But for the $17.99, which is the price it costs right now, you get the iPhone and iPad version, which is great. The average rating right now is 4.7 out of 5 stars. Again, people like it. Released in 2014, last update October 2019, version 5.26, again at time of this video. So this is basically a drum machine and it has MIDI capability. We can use something like the Morningstar MC8 or the Line 6 Helix to control it, which makes it a drummer in a box, which this is great for jamming, songwriting, practicing. It's so important to practice to a metronome and this is so much more fun than the metronome. Let's take a look at the app right now and see what it looks like. When you load up on your iPad, it looks just like this. I find with these apps, when you first load them up, they can be confusing. You have to spend time with them and learn them like an instrument. You really do. And I'm going to give you an overview now. I probably can't cover every single feature. This isn't a tutorial. I can make one of those in the future if I get enough interest. But I want to give you an overview and show you how I would use it and also how I would use it with MIDI, because that did confuse me for a while and it doesn't need to confuse you. It's not that hard. So let's take a look at the app. Let's start from the top left. That big flashing button is your play button, and if I press it, you get your drums. Let me load a more interesting beat. So you can hear it sounds great, and that's the most important thing with this, right? The drums have to sound real, and I think they do. I think they sound really good. Okay, let's just work our way to the right. So we've got tap tempo, tap on that, and it gives you your BPM. Below that, if you hold and pull down or push up, you can change very quickly the BPM, and the plus or minus allows you to change gradually. Now the fill and count, they confused me initially. The fill actually means it will play a fill and then play the beat, and it will play a fill and then end the beat. The count means it will count you in, and on this one it's just a one bar count in. So if I press count and then press fill, count in, fill in, beat. Press fill again, it played a fill and finished it. Makes it very natural and real, very cool. Let's keep going to the right. Swing, obviously the amount of swing in your beat. So for a very straightforward rock beat, you leave it all the way to the left. Jam intensity, it will throw in more things. If it's turned up high, it'd be like a real drummer throwing in those fancy little things here and there to show off. If you just want the beat with nothing else, keep it all the way to the left. I like that. Sometimes I just want to have like a drum machine, basically. I just want to have a very straightforward thing. So it's nice that they give you that option. Bars to fill, none, 4, 8, 12, 16. It'll automatically play a fill every 4, 8, 12, or 16 bars. You can just select it here. Again, I want to decide when my fills come in, so I'm going to put it on no. So it's a very straightforward, boring thing so far. I'm sorry about that. But this is my preference when I'm practicing and jamming most of the time. Now, to the right of that, effects, compression, EQ, delay, and reverb. I'll cover those later on. They are awesome. I'm so glad they're built into the app. That's great. Then we have Link. This is Ableton Link, so you can make it sync with other apps. I'll cover that in another video, because that's a whole new thing. For now, I'll leave it off. Then there's our MIDI controls right there. Nothing too crazy. I've got this on MIDI channel 12. I keep all my stuff on different channels, so this is on 12. The map below that shows you what's being sent out. You can actually send this MIDI information out to other apps. I've seen people use the drums here to trigger like keyboards, so it kind of jams with the keyboard in a way. But I think what this actually is meant for is if you load another drum app, which has a drum module, say brushes, then you could send the MIDI out of this, the MIDI in of that, and then this rhythm will play with the brushes, will play with those sounds. I think that's really what it's meant for. And indeed, you can use these Lumbeat apps together. So the rock drummer pattern can trigger the brushes from the soft drummer app. Very cool. Again, I wish they were in one app, but it's good that they can talk to each other like that. Below that is our MIDI settings. I have MIDI in right now on the Bluetooth. I'm using Bluetooth MIDI. Just for this video, I generally use a cable whenever I can. I don't trust wireless gear, especially in New York City. Too much traffic around. But for this video, I've got to do it so I can show you the editor as well. Whatever device you're using, just set it there. So MIDI in, if it's a Helix, it will say Helix, select Helix. If you want the MIDI clock in to come from that device, also set the MIDI clock in as well. So that's pretty straightforward. Again, MIDI can be covered in another video, but their settings are all there and they're great. Next, we have the iCloud icon. So we can load and save iCloud backups. Again, thank you, Lumbeat. Great feature. Then the information button is basically a sales pitch for the other apps, but there they are. And they're all great. Like I said, I like the reggae drummer icon. They're all right there. In fact, all the icons are really cool. They're all there. They're all great. I haven't tried them all yet. But you know, this developer is excellent. The sounds are great. iBassist is something we'll look at in the future. It's very cool. Now, on the right of that, we have song mode. This allows you to bring in different beats and craft songs, like a full song with intro, fill, verse, fill. You can select when the cymbals come on and crash or not. You can select if there's a fill between parts or not. And you can save it as a song and make a set list. Now, right now, I don't use this feature. I like to work a different way, but this is a great way to work if you want to create more of a backing track. So that's the song mode. There's also a loop button there as well, so it'll keep playing it. But that is a nice feature. Sound module, you have to turn that on if you're going to play like an electronic drum kit through the thing or a keyboard and use the buttons on the keyboard. You can also assign MIDI notes from a MIDI controller. So on your Line 6 Helix, you could find which note is the kick drum, and then one of your buttons on your Helix can be a kick drum. So during the song, you can just tap on a physical button on the Helix that and you'll get a kick drum come through. The only issue I have with this is that you have to turn it on. So if you want to do that, you have to turn it on, press down the buttons to your kick drum, and then turn it off again if you want to go back to regular drums, okay? So I wish I didn't have to turn it on for that. I wish it could be independent, but that's how it works for now. And I don't know if that could be changed or not. Below that, here's the main screen, right? On the far left, bank. So you've got rock, grunge, funk. These are presets, basically. And if you make a new beat, it will go into user. If you find a beat that you love, say I like Rooster, press the star icon and it will save it into favorites. So it's always there. I advise you to do that. If you find something you like, make it a favorite. Then in rhythm, that's obviously the different rhythms within the bank. So that's pretty simple to scroll through them. That's great. You can choose one of those and you can press edit and you can change that and then save it as your own beat and it will save it right into the user bank. Very cool. Now to the right of that is our sounds. So this is interesting. This is all different kits. Look how many there are. It's really great. Let me play one and we'll see what they sound like. That's RR Big, Rock Bin, Roomy Rock Bin, Attack, Clean Ride, Light. So I like light because I think the other ones are kind of very powerful sounding. I like the light sound. And if you press the lock button here, whenever you change one of the rhythms or banks, it won't change the sound of the drums. So all your drums will be the same sound. That's a nice feature. I like that a lot. Okay, so sound also has these dots next to it. And that's kind of hiding the menu from the bottom, just repeated, but also groove times two and like half time and double time. That's hidden away. I wish it wasn't hidden away, but you might want that. So you can actually do double time and half time. That's a really cool thing. I wish it wasn't hidden away in there, but I'm glad that it's there. Right, now let's go down to the bottom. Edit. This lets you edit the pattern. So The pattern is on the screen here when I choose one. Let me just find a simple one, like that, right? So if I press play. Now that might work for me. I might want to change the swing or the jam intensity. That may well work for me. Now, if it doesn't, all I got to do is tap on the screen on one of the blocks here and I can change the rhythm. So let's see. If I put one here. You hear that? So you can customize this. The far left one means nothing. And then you can put the gray or the white or the red. There we go. Or you can get rid of it again. One tip that I just recently found out about, if you hold down, it highlights the whole bar and then pull down, you can get more subdivisions. So you can get it like this and that sound like this. Yeah, that can be useful. So this is powerful. Now, if you like that, you can press save and you can name it. I'll just call it test, save. That's now in my user bank, save forever. If you're good at programming, this is amazing. I wish you could import like MIDI files and other people's drum beats, but if you can program drums, you could even program them as you're playing, if you think about it. And at the top right here, we have new groove and random. If you press random, it just gives you a random groove, which is nice. So you can just jam over that. If you press new groove, this is very useful. If you're creating something from scratch, say I want 4-4, do 4-4. I want the hats on the eights. I want the snare on the offbeats and the kick on the onbeats. You can just quickly get a beat like that as a template. Press play. Change your tempo. Choose your kit. Look at that. Straight away, I got what I need. That's really cool. I can add things in if they're required like that. So I think that's excellent. Let me do another one. New groove. I'll stay in 4-4 because I'm boring today. Hats pattern. Let's do 16ths. Let's do the snare on the beat. Check out what this sounds like. Okay, so very quick to get started. You can get started with that and then edit it, save it, and you're done. Now on the right at the bottom here, we have patterns. You can choose a different pattern. Then we have sounds, so you can choose the actual sounds for the kick, the snare, or the hats and customize your own kit. Then we have mixer. This is great. If the snare's too loud, you can just bring the volume down and you can pan and mute completely and tweak the whole mix here. Very useful. Again, love that. Then we have effects. We can turn reverb, delay, EQ, and compression on or off and edit the parameters inside. These correspond to the buttons up the top. So let me turn reverb on, see what that sounds like. So I can turn that up here. That's a lot of reverb. Turn it down. But again, I'm so happy that those effects are built into the app and not external. That's really great. Now let's go into jamming. We have jam intensity. So again, it lets you set the jam intensity, same as it does up the top. It's like a shortcut up the top there. But also you can say I want it on hat, snare, or kick. So you can select or deselect them, have it on just one or the other. That's great. Again, you can tweak it, right? You can also tweak again the bars for a fill. 4, 8, 12, 16, also 24 or 32, some extra options in there. Thank you. Thank you for having 32 as an option. That's really great. I'll leave that on off though. Crash cymbal after fill, always after fill, usually, sometimes, seldom, or never. Brilliant. Thank you for that feature. Thank you for making it so customizable. So that's all along the bottom here. Next one is live pads. This is probably the most important one for me because when you first press it, you'll see it shows you the MIDI commands there. They're program changes and everything is listed. So using those, we can control via MIDI and I'll show you how you do that. You can also control with your finger as well. So if you press play, now if you press the fill button here on this live pad screen, you'll get a fill. You press the picture of the crash cymbal, you get a crash on beat one. If you press fill and toggle hi-hats, this is brilliant. It will go from the hi-hat to the ride cymbal. So say we've got a chorus coming up, check this out. See, that alone is enough for a chorus variation, I think. And we'll go back again. It's great. And then each of these eight pads that you see in front of you, kick only, drive, snaring, you can set those to be your own beats. So you could have, I have one that's kick only, right? So if during the song I want a breakdown, I do this. It's like a breakdown. And then when I want to go back into the song again, I just press on drive. If I selected fill every change on the right here, it will put a fill in when I change to drive. So there's my kick, press drive. There was a fill, right? And every time you change pads, you'll get a fill. Using this, we can really play a song with a band. Like if you play with a bass player and you play guitar, this could be amazing, like really amazing. And like I said, you can assign all the pads and those controls to your MIDI controller. And I'll show you how to do that next. I think if you're gonna use this live, yes, you can use your hand. I love the iPad on the stand because yes, you can use your fingers to select things. That's fine. I don't mind doing that. But you also want it on the floor as well. So if you take a look at my MC8, this isn't a sponsored video. This is just a great MIDI controller simply because it's 8 buttons. It's quite small. It's easy to press the buttons. The buttons at the back are high. The ones at the front are small. I'll make a review of this, but the screen as well makes this a great MIDI controller. Now, everything we're doing here can also be done on any other MIDI controller as long as it supports program changes. And also the Line 6 Helix supports that. So you could have all this on your Helix. The only problem I have with that is that it takes up buttons that I might want to use for other stuff. So that's why I would use this and the Helix. And remember, if you purchase the camera connection kit that I mentioned in episode 1 of this series, then you can connect your Helix to your iPad or iPhone with one cable. And using that, you can control these MIDI commands and send the audio of the drums straight through the Helix, which are unaffected by the guitar sounds. So you can then play the Helix guitar sounds over the top of those drums, and they'll go straight out to the PA system through one XLR to the desk. You don't have to worry about routing this audio out to mixers or external devices. You can run everything through a Line 6 Helix, which makes it a great partner for these apps. So this is how I have it set up. You can set up any way you like. Start, stop, fill, toggle between hi-hat or ride cymbal, fill and start or fill and end, tap tempo if you need it. You might be doing that from somewhere else. Crash cymbal on the beat one and kick, which just goes to that pad with a kick. Let me show you how I might use it live. I might choose the beat. This is the only thing. I wish there was a way to use the MIDI controller to choose the set of pads from the app. Now that's in Soft Drummer. I think it's coming to this app in the future. Well, I hope it is. There'll be a button so you can go into load, and then you can use a button to select the group of pads that you're going to use. And then you can press obviously fill and start. The tempo is set by the pads. If the developer's watching, I love this app, but I am a performer and I'm looking at ways to use the apps live. And I would love it if there's a simple way to quickly load up a song. And not a song, I don't want to use the song mode. I want to use the pad mode. I want to load a bank of pads and go, all with my feet. It'd be great. And also a way to link into, say, on song, so I can choose in between on song and then in between loads on here with that set of pads. Not the song, the pads. I love the pad mode. So I think they're almost there. And I would still use this live, but I think with a bit of tweaking, this could be the ultimate live drummer. It really could. Sorry, drummers that are watching. This thing is great. It's always on time and never misses a beat. So this is what I got. I got start and stop. I want to play the song. I'm going to say, give me a fill and start the song. There we go. That's fine. That's my verse, right? Now let's put a fill in now with my foot. There it was. Oh, I want to crash just for effect on this next word I'm going to sing. So, 1, 2. There we go. Okay, we come to the chorus. Let's toggle from the hi-hat to the ride cymbal. You see the difference? Like, that's great for a chorus, that big sound. Let's go back to the verse again. Back to a verse. Oh, let's do a drop down sing-along section. Let's press the kick button. Put your hands up in the air. Let's go back to the song again. I'm gonna tap on the screen. Let me get back to some sort of beat. Okay, nice. And that can be anything that you want. And then I can press these two. I can now access the pads. So I want this pad here. That's the kick drum. I want this pad here. These are things that I made myself. Let's try this one. So you could in fact have 8 songs here. Each pad could be a song. Not the way I want to use it, but you could do that. Go back again. Fill. I have a crash every time. Isn't it brilliant? This is great. Let's end the song with a fill and end. And you get that crash symbol at the end that just fades off. I love that, the way it just rings out. So as you can see, once the song is loaded from the app, let me just show you the app again. Once the song is loaded here, or your set of pads is loaded here, you are good to go with this MIDI controller. The MIDI controller is awesome. But again, the only problem I have sometimes is getting into that song. If OnSong could select that bank of pads and then I control it with my feet, that's what I want. Anyway, let me show you how you set this up. Again, here is the MC8 control screen. If you buy one of these, the MC6, the MC8, believe it or not, this isn't a sponsored video, but I do love the product. You can use any MIDI controller. There's so many available, but I do think you need to use a MIDI controller with these apps to get the most from them live or anytime. So I'll just talk you through what I've got here. I have start, stop. Okay, so on here I've got short name, start, stop, long name, start, stop, same thing. Message one, okay, it's a press, which is a program change, or PC. PC number 13, which I got from the app. Remember I showed you on the app earlier? It shows you that at the top left, look, PC 13 is play. So all I did is I went back to this screen. I put in PC 13 on MIDI channel 12, which is the MIDI channel of the app. Let me show you that as well. At the top there, you see that MIDI channel 12? So that's all I did. That's so simple. Anyone can do this. MIDI channel 12, program number 13. When I pressed, I have to press save. And then when you plug it in, you press that button, you get start, stop. The next one I have is fill. So exactly the same thing, but PC number is 8. Next one I have is toggle between hi-hat and ride. That's number 12. You can write these down if you don't look in the app, but they're all in the app, so don't worry about that too much. Fill start or fill end is 11. Crash on beat 1 is 9. And then all my pads there were on different numbers. These are my pads. So the top left pad is 0, then 1, then 2, etc. So that's it. It's absolutely amazing. It's an all-in-one, very highly customizable app. If you have something like a Helix, you can plug this in with one cable. The audio just goes straight through the Helix out to the mains, and you can choose a beat and just start jamming. And if you have a bass player with you, I mean, this is amazing, right? This is such a cool app. I absolutely love it. I've jammed to it so much in preparing to make this video, and even the last few weeks, I've jammed so much with this app. And I think it's just so great for your timing, and it makes it more fun. Because it's one thing to sit and play electric guitar at home, but if you can play electric guitar to a drummer, it's great for your timing, and it's just so much more fun to do. I can see myself using this live. Look, I want to use this live. The foot controller makes it so easy to do that, especially if you're willing to also control the app with your hand. But bearing in mind that I want to explore multiple apps in the future, I do need this to have a way to talk to, let's say, OnSong. So I choose my song and it loads up that set of pads and I control them with my feet. I also noticed when I first load the app that the fill button doesn't work. So when I first load up the app and press start, I can't then use the fill control. I have to go to live pads, and then everything's fine, and whatever I change, everything works perfectly. But if those two things are improved, I can't think of much else to improve on this app. It's just absolutely brilliant, and I hope that you agree with me. If you've used this app, please let me know in the comments below. If you have any thoughts on it or ways that it could be better, let me know in the comments below. If you liked the video, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't like the video, give me a thumbs up. And please remember to subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so you're notified when I upload my next video on iOS apps, acoustic guitars, electric guitars, or anything in that kind of area. So thanks for watching. I hope this made sense. Feel free to ask questions and comment below. I'll see you in the next episode. And I've got so many cool things coming, but I love this app and I encourage you to buy it and start jamming with some drums, especially right now when we're doing a lot of jamming by ourselves, right? So be well. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.